Hello, everyone, and welcome to All Things Aesthetics and Wellness podcast with me, your host, Dr. Deborah Jurist, and my co-host.
Hey, guys, Ferdy Golombieski, nurse practitioner here at Revitalize MD, and today we are talking about healing peptides.
That's right. So there are a couple different, well, we use a slew of peptides. We love them, but there are a couple that we will use for healing in particular. And so we want to talk a little bit about those. You know, we've already done some podcasts and have actually even had guests on that talked about their experiences with BPC. Nice. But that is one of our main go-tos for healing, which is BPC-157.
Yes.
If you haven't heard of it, then what it is a peptide, and a peptide is an amino acid sequence. So they are synthetic, but they do mimic the neurotransmitters or hormones in the body. So this is actually a neurotransmitter in the stomach that is meant for repair. So basically body protective compound, and it comes from gastric juices. So, yeah,
so it can help for some GI issues too, even though that's what it's less known for. It's more known for its tendon healing and decrease of inflammation in the body. And that's really where our patients have really benefited from BPC, is that decreased inflammation. And it's helped reduce pain from chronic inflammation over the years.
Chronic or acute injuries, which is what we'll use it for. And then they get chronic improvement. So there's lots of different conditions you can use BPC 157. But coming from gastric juices, the big thing is there's lots of acid production in the stomach. And so there could be injury. And so it was produced in the stomach to protect the body from damage from strong stomach acid. So it actually can be, most of our peptides are in injectable form. They are prescription only from a compounding pharmacy and prescribed by a physician. This is one that you could use in the capsule form. I think I would only recommend that if it was a stomach related issue.
Exactly.
But even then, an injection would work to help it. So we
just see better results with injectables. We've prescribed both because, you know, every patient has their own individualized plan that they need that works best for them. So those that are just very needle adverse, we try oral. But even with that, we just don't see the same level of improvement.
Yes, correct.
Like we do with injectables.
So this is one that you can use for, again, any acute injury, tendon, ligament, bone. And again, you don't have to do it. It's systemic, so it works no matter where you put it. But there is some, you know, argument for putting it closest to the injury if you can. But it doesn't matter. It's still going to work systemic. And it's funny because people will use it for an acute injury, and then they've had some chronic back pain, or they've had chronic pain in another area, and they get improvement of that too. So it does work systemically no matter where you put it. But people love this peptide.
And what's really nice with this peptide is usually peptides take a little while to work. And some take, you know, 4, 5, 6 months before you see improvement. I feel like most patients with BPC have seen that improvement.
Usually within 2 weeks.
Exactly. Yeah. Some of them, depending on the extent, if they have a ton of inflammation, sometimes it's more, you know, give it the full month. Mm-hmm. But still, when we're talking about medicine and we're talking about functional change like that, and the type of relief our patients are seeing with this peptide, to say you should see a difference 2 to 4 weeks is
amazing.
Amazing.
Yeah. And I usually say try it at least for 60 days. Usually people will get improvement within 2 weeks. The longer the pain or condition's been there, the longer it's going to take. I usually say try it for at least 2 months before, and most people have had improvement by 2 months. But it also works to improve lots of other different things, potential ocular injuries, corneal abrasions. Yeah. If you're having surgery, the quicker you get on it before, you can do it in the preoperative, the perioperative, and the post. So it allows inflammation, but it actually limits the inflammation, which is why you have such pain, limited range of motion, say, for instance, a knee surgery, an ACL repair. You get inflamed. You can't move it.
Yep.
You can't heal. So this allows inflammation, but not too much of it. So you get better healing.
So we have patients that come in that have acute injuries, right? Mm-hmm. So bicep tears. We've seen it for that. Or, hey, I tweaked my knee at the gym. Or, hey, I've got tennis elbow or golfer's elbow. Or, oh, my wrists are bothering me. So something that they've done acute inflammation. Mm-hmm. We've done it for chronic. We've seen it for, like Dr. Dersh was saying, we have patients that are saying, hey, I have knee surgery scheduled. Mm-hmm. We'll start BPC right before surgery and then continue it post-surgery.
And the recovery is so much like faster. And so there's been a couple that have been in for just hormones. They were due for surgery, put them on BPC.
Shoulder surgery.
Oh, yeah. And quickly they were up and active, or range of motion was good. But again, like if somebody's having any kind of surgery, period, you know, it's great for colon, small intestinal surgery. So in repair of those and quicker recovery time. So just things to think about. You know, we've tried it for gums and all kinds of
toothpaste.
Things. Yeah, toothpaste.
That's right.
All kinds of different
toothpaste
things.
For gum health.
Yeah, so there's all kinds of things. And in fact, there's a lot of people that will come in with a certain condition. And we've never used it for that condition before, but if you Google, somebody has with good improvement. So there's tons of things we don't even know that we can use it for, but it's not a drug. We use it in an injectable form for the most effective route, but it's not a drug. It doesn't have interactions, you know, and so you can use it indefinitely, really.
Absolutely.
If you want to. And a lot of people do want to do that because they feel so good on it. So, and if ever we pair it with a growth hormone peptide, like, such as CJC-1295.
Or Ipamorlin.
Yes, which are usually together in the same product, it will increase growth hormone receptor sensitivity in the brain. So sometimes pairing that with a growth hormone peptide is good because then you get max benefits from both. So
absolutely.
So TB-500 was the other one we wanted. We used to do TB-4. Which was a great anti-inflammatory healing peptide, but then they have limited the use of that just recently, and I think it's a transient thing, but some COVID type of issues. And so, again, that hasn't went over very well.
And TB-500 is a synthetic fraction of
TB-4.
So we've been able to kind of swap those two out and interchange them with really great success.
Yeah.
So you never really know until you start and you go, okay, well, TB-4 was great for XYZ. Let's see if we see these same results. And we are very happy that we are seeing that, especially when it comes to healing and inflammation.
One, especially since it is just a small segment of, and again, when we're talking about TB-500 or TB-4, it's thymosin beta 4 or thymosin 500 and or thymosin beta 500. Okay. So it's just a small segment. So it works, you know, just as well. We just had been so used to and love the results of TB-4. But switching over has not been an issue whatsoever.
We haven't, which has been wonderful. Mm-hmm. And that was another reason why we wanted to do this podcast, is because now we have patients that have been on it for a while and we're seeing these great results, so that we can speak about it confidently and go, yes, we can use this. We are seeing these great results. Mm-hmm. Even better when we're taking the TB-500 and pairing it with
BPC.
BPC.
Yeah. I mean, I think that's the go-to route, honestly.
It's crazy, the healing that we're seeing with that. We have patients that have had some pretty significant injuries. They're out already 6 months post-surgery. They're still having some pain. And we've been able to do both of those combo treatments and seen reduction in pain, more mobility. They're back to doing all the things they love to do. So it's been wonderful on our end and for our patients.
And I absolutely love the, I mean, I think BPC is not something that I would not personally do TB-500 without BPC. And so we really have used both in combination just because we love BPC. And even when it was TB-4, we were still doing it with, I mean, BPC is like almost a go-to that everyone should be on. I'm a little crazed about that peptide product.
But that's okay.
That's okay.
Really we've had patients that have come in and said, hey, do you do TB-500. You know, they've come in and request it because they've done the research. A lot of our patients come to us doing the research, or they've listened to a podcast and said, hey, I heard you guys do BPC 157. Have you ever used TB-500? And if so, what are those results? And can we put it together? Or can you just order that? So a lot of the things that we end up doing in office, our patients are coming in and requesting it.
Yeah, everything is customized to the patient. And we're not going to do anything that the patient requests. But again, our patients are more proactive than other, you know, traditionally trained providers. And so when they bring us something, it's worth looking at.
Absolutely.
And then if we find it to be something that has a purpose, then we will introduce it.
And medical validity, of course, always. Of course,
yes, no, absolutely. So we review and investigate every single thing we bring into the practice, and we will only bring it in if it's comprehensive with our, you know, treatment model. And so everything is medically based, and we do a lot of research before we bring anything in. So if some, but I love when patients bring me things I haven't thought about. So somebody else was doing fat transfer to a breast in a previous breast surgery and wanted to do PRP with the fat transfer. We don't do fat transfers. Gave me some research that supports that the fat transfer lasts longer with the PRP, but the surgeon doesn't do it. So we'll do PRP after. So just even, I hadn't even read about it because we don't do fat transfers, but just opening our minds to things we haven't thought about or learned about is, you know, it's growth for us
exactly.
as a practice and as providers. So,
and anything we can do regenerative, anytime we can promote the body to do what it is naturally supposed to do and heal itself naturally, we are always on board.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Absolutely.
Any way to stay off of long-term NSAIDs or like ibuprofen, Advil, which are so terrible for the body long-term.
So NSAIDs, like there's not almost, not NSAIDs, but acid-reducing medicines. There's not almost anybody that I haven't been able to get off those with BPC-157. Yes. Just so you know. And gastric acid is important. You just don't want it to go overboard and cause damage, but you do need it. And so beyond those, acid reducers are not beneficial for you long term. So anyhow, we're going to wrap this up, but these are some healing peptides that we use, BPC-157, TB-500. TB-500 is also injectable and systemically absorbed once injected, just so you know. So they both are.
But they can be used individually or together. Our preference is together.
Yeah, together.
Or
if a patient requests it.
Or patient requested, yes.
Yes.
But we do love BPC-157. It's probably our favorite. Yeah. Before we close up, always good to remind patients not to purchase peptides online if they are not sure that they can validate the source. So that is probably one of the most common questions that we get is, well, can you just buy online? Well, I know there are places you can, but the source is, who knows?
You don't know about the purity of a source. So do not buy online.
The validity.
Do not buy something that's investigational only. No animal use.
For animal consumption only.
Yeah. So, but definitely we're here to answer questions. So if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. And any experience with peptides, please let us know. And again, you know, if you want to hear anything else, anything more about peptides, just let us know. We're here to and willing to talk about anything, medical aesthetics or wellness. And so let us know. And again, we're here to revitalize your luck, your health, and your sex life.
Thank you.
Thank you.